We bid welcome thee, we bid share in our feasting and our revelry, our music and our company. To be or not to be, that is the question that bothered me. Am I who I seem be, a jester in all this finery, or perhaps beneath this fair face, another being takes his place, a jouster, or perhaps a knight? Do I dream, or am I right? I could joust among the best, a knight? Just put me to the test, and my mettle I will prove my strength. A rock cannot move. And so, dear guest, please be aware that what you see may not be there. A tournament with knights on horses? Silly. Some could say that. Of course it is. Hey, you try to rhyme something with horses.
Fool, you were speaking about me, I bet.
Why, Merton Sire, your ears ringing?
Your ding-a-linging gesture bells have far too many decibels for any ear to disregard. Though try I do try hard. But hold your bells and do not ring, for I am bringing this message to the king.
A message for the king? Whatever would he want with thee?
As you well know, I am Merton Sire, Lord of Misrule and General Attaché to the king, in all matters of etiquette and decorum.
Merton Sire, I've heard that for many a year, and I still don't know what it means, I fear.
Simply put, you simple fool, I have the king's ear.
You have the king's ear? And you better return it to him quick. A king who is earless is bound to get sick.
We'll see how funny you think you are when you hear that important visitors are coming from afar.
Perhaps the king and his family are soon to be in our midst.
How did you know it was a family? Never mind. It seems a knight in our midst has a king for a father, so goes a jizz. His family will come and watch our tournament and cheer on their son in this sporting event. I've heard several courtiers surmise that this king from afar is bringing a prize for the knight who is victorious. I have half a mind to enter myself. It would be glorious.
Finally, Merton Sire, you and I both agree. You have half a mind, you see.
Now you see here.
Oh, I do see, and I do hear, though you still have a good king's ear. You know for a fact that you must give it back, for a king who is earless can never be fearless. Oh, look at the time! A royal procession begins anon. Trumpets, blow thy clarion call, and singers, hie thee to the hall.
Welcome. and ladies, our gracious host bids you rise for our wassail toast.
A toast to our queen, Lady Jack. May health and happiness attend thee. May every joy of every season be yours, and may we be blessed by providence with longevity.
Yeah, yeah.
And to you, our most noble liege, to our blessed King of England, Lord Ethan.
Hear, hear!
A toast to the lords and gentlemen, the rulers and masters of our person, and the children of our household. To the men, I say, to our good husbands, lords, and counselors.
Hear, hear!
A toast to the ladies of this hall, the ones who are the quiet strength of our lives, the dearest flowers in our hearts. To our wives, and our sisters, and our daughters and nieces.
Hear, hear!
And now, a toast to our guests. May the peace and joy of Christmastide within our hearts this year abide. Drink it well, you noble kind, on this the eve of our Yuletide. Now let us toast. Down with him who will not say, all hail wassail!
All hail wassail!
Please be seated.
It is said that long ago, a young student was studying the quiet Nottingham Forest when suddenly that quiet was broken and she lowered her book of Aristotle to see charging her at full tilt was a mighty wild boar.
Whereat the student raised her book of Aristotle again, but this time threw it sharply into the boar's jaw like Requiemest. Thus, as the saying goes, she choked the savage with the sage. Now the boar's head is at the procession to symbolize wit over evil.
My friends, the hour progresses, and all this merriment has been growing more ravenously. My good prince, we await.
Guests must not soil the cloth with their knife nor rest their legs upon the table. Guests must never leave bones on the table. Always hide them under your chairs.
Guests must not wipe their greasy fingers on their beards. Guests must not lean on the table with their elbows, nor dip their thumbs in their drinks. And guests must always retain their knives, or they shall be forced to grab with their fingers.
We thank you, Lord Steward and Chamberlains. Now let us begin our feast. My good prince, we await you.
Before our feast, we thank our God for friends and loved ones dear, the ones we gather in our homes as the holidays draw near.
Our heads we bow, our hands we fold, our hearts we offer as of old, and thanks for food and fellowship and shelter from the cold.
What did you get?
Oh, what?
That's because he wanted me to give you this. His modesty outweighs his generosity.
Oh, thank you!
Fool, this letter isn't for me at all.
Let me see. Oh, see here, it's directed to a Wes.
See, that isn't even my name.
Dear Wes Hale, we hope you're
well.
We hope you are well and we miss you. We have heard about the tournament to be held in your land. They say that the best and the bravest knights from far and wide will be coming to do battle against you. We wanted you to know that we love and support you. So the whole family is coming to cheer you on. Oh no. We're on our way. We would have been there by now, but your father didn't want to ask for directions. Loves and kisses, Mom and Dad. This is terrible! Could it be any worse? P.S. Your sister is getting married. Oh, this is horrible!
I know! I don't even have a sister!
Merton, sorry, this isn't about you.
It's not? Since when?
Since I've known you, it's about me.
Nonsense. Because look here, it says here it's addressed to a Wes Hale. Don't even think it!
Yes, and my name would be...
Your name is... Fool!
A title I wear all too proudly, but alas, not my given name. Let me tell you a story. Hey, you listen here. There might be a test. Long ago, there lived a young prince in a far-off kingdom. More than anything, this prince loved to make people laugh. But his father, the king, wanted him to learn the ways of being a knight. So, when he was old enough, his father sent him to a different kingdom to learn the ways of jousting. And when he got there, he presented his letter of introduction to the king. And you know what? He didn't learn the ways of knighthood. Much to his delight, he learned how to be a jester. And he was happy making people laugh. Well, most people laugh anyway. And he lived for many years very happily.
But what about his family?
An excellent question. He may have helped his family along by writing them letters of his heroic exploits and daring do's and grand acts of chivalry and so on and so forth.
You lie!
Let's not go that far.
You said this wasn't about me.
It's not. It's about me.
Oh.
Marty, my name is Wesley Alvin Hale, but everyone always shortens my name to Wes Hale.
Wes Hale!
You're supposed to be a brave and valiant knight?
I know. I'm not a knight. I'm just a jester. My family will be here any minute. What do I do?
You could send a messenger before they arrive to tell them the tournament's been canceled.
No, that will never... Wait a minute, that's genius. Marty, are you sure you thought of that?
Where you're concerned, I am certain of nothing. Call for the messenger!
Announcing from the far-off kingdom of New Palestine, King William Hale, Queen Beatrice Hale, and Princess Ava Hale. Hail, hail, hail! The gang's all here!
Let's get this tournament started.
Marty, quick! What's Plan B?
What's always Plan B? Plan B's to run away!
Thank you.
for the evening is already at your tables. And if you have not done so already, dig in.
Any sign of my family?
The coast appears to be clear.
Okay, you know the plan.
Right, plan B is
the plan. No, not that plan. The new plan. The plan where you tell my family that the tournament has been canceled.
Ah, that plan.
Right. Now, my father is a very clever man.
Most kings are.
He will no doubt try to trick you into telling him the truth.
Fool, please. I am a member of the king's court, a politician in essence. I am incapable of telling the truth.
Listen, where are you?
Oh, that's it.
Ah, Jesse, perhaps you can help me.
Don't bother yourself with that poor fellow. He's a mute, you see. Doesn't speak a word.
Is that right?
That's right.
You sound familiar. Do I know you?
Sire, you flatter me. Though I am well known, I am Mert, sire, lord of misrule, and
general— I was speaking to the jester.
Of course you were, and I was speaking for the jester. See, when I said he didn't speak a word, I meant he didn't speak a word of English. He only speaks Finnish.
Really? Have him say something Finnish.
Say something Finnish.
Finnish?
I haven't even started yet!
Wesley!
It is you! I thought you sounded familiar.
Oh, Wesley, we've missed you so much.
Mom, Dad, I miss you too.
Wes, guess what? I got your old room.
What? Where will I sleep when I visit? The dungeon?
She only keeps it until she's married. Then she'll move in with her husband.
Wes, what's with the get-up?
Oh, this old thing.
Wesley, you haven't gone funny on this, have you?
Depends on what you mean by funny.
I think it's brilliant.
You do?
Yes. In fact, it's wonderful.
Wow, Dad. Thanks. I'm so relieved, and here I was worried that you'd be angry when you found out that I
dressed up as a jester to get a jump on your competition.
Come again.
You see, Wesley here knew that given his reputation as the finest, bravest, fiercest knight there is, and why shouldn't he be? He's my son. He wouldn't get anywhere near the other knights in the tournament to see them practice and find out their weaknesses.
Yes, about the tournament.
But by putting on this ridiculous outfit, he can spy on them and they won't suspect a thing. Bravo. Well done. And thanks to you as well.
You're welcome, but what did I do?
Why, you lent him your motley outfit. Almost had me fooled, pretending to be a gentleman.
Pretending to be?
Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to go see who my new son-in-law is going to be.
What's he talking about? What new son-in-law?
Oh, you know your father. Once he gets an idea in his head, it just stays there.
Ah, yes. I know that well.
Mertenside, when you get an idea in your head, it dies of loneliness.
Just for that, I wore my outfit back.
Your father decided some time ago that it was time for your sister to get married. But he won't let me marry the man I love. He really is beneath you, dear.
Who?
That's your trouble.
The fishmonger?
You're in love.
You. And the fishmonger?
You know what they say, love is blind.
Blind, yes, but it still has a sense of smell.
Children, please. Your father wants only the best for you, sweetheart. That's why, when he heard about this whole tournament, he decreed that the winner would receive your sister's hand in marriage.
What?
The winner would be the best, and the best is what he wants for you, dear.
That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard.
I know. But like I said, once he gets an idea in his head,
I can't believe you agreed to this.
I can't believe you think I had a choice. Don't worry, I have a brilliant plan, and it can't fail. You.
Me can't.
You know you can't fail.
Me can't.
Wes, you've said so in all your letters. You're a brave and valiant knight, and you're going to win the tournament. And since I can't marry my own brother, I'll be free to marry Thatcher.
The fishmonger.
What do you say?
I say you're going to need the newest plan B.
The newest plan B? I never knew the original plan B.
The newest plan B is where I tell your father that the tournament has been canceled and you all go home at once.
Oh no, Then Father will just find another tournament, one you wouldn't be entered in, Wes.
He won't be entered in this one either.
What do you mean?
I mean that he is a fool.
Don't be silly. That's just a disguise so that he can get close to the other knights. Father said so. Isn't that right, Wes? Wes?
He's right, I am. I let you believe I was a brave and valiant knight when really, I am just a jester.
Just a jester? You're serious, you are the court jester? And you were giving me a hard time about marrying a fishmonger?
Jester, fishmonger, at least I'm still in the royal court.
Oh no, if you can't win the tournament for me, what am I going to do?
If I had it my way, you'd marry your furniture and smell like fish the rest of your happy life.
Lemon juice. Cleanse yourself in lemon juice. Takes the fish smell right out.
Thanks, Wesley. Although you're not a knight, you are pretty valiant. Thanks for this hit.
Lemon juice?
I am the general attaché to the king in all manners of etiquette and decorum. I know something about looking and smelling nice.
Do you know anything about jousting?
You're jesting.
I can't let my sister marry some complete stranger. I need a crash course in crashing on horses.
On horses?
Of courses. I can't just be a jesting jouster. I need to be a jousting jester. Oh, woe is me. Who will come to my aid? Nay, who will come to my aid?
Are you serious?
Nay, who will come to my aid, dressed as knights, carrying a squarish table, and chanting an obscure song?
1, 2, 3, 4, 4, 3, 2, 1. We are the knights of squarish table. We do the best that we are able. Look to south, east, to west. We are the knights who are the best. 4, 3, 2, 1. We are the knights of the table square. Some say our costumes are quite garish. Look to south, west, to east. We come join this happy feast. 4, 3, 2, 1. Our squarish table, we are knights. Traveling round and picking fights. Arr! This is west, north to south. Looking for tracks to punch the map. 4, 3, 2, 1. The knights of the squarish table. We are less than 5, more than 3. This is west, north to south.
Has anybody seen a horse? No, guys, I'm serious. My feet are killing me.
Just the brave knights I've been looking for.
Get me going, knight.
Knight.
Prince.
Prince, we know who you really are. Your father told us everything.
You are a prince and a knight.
And you're a fool to think we'll let you find out our weaknesses.
Not that we have weaknesses.
So off, run away.
But I'm not a knight. I'm a jester.
We fail to see the humor.
It's not supposed to be funny!
I say, he's not a very good jester, is he?
I beg your pardon. He may not be a brave and valiant knight, but he is a talented and witty jester. The finest in 20 kingdoms, more or less. Now, are you going to help him become a knight, or do I have to start giving you makeovers?
He'll need a horse,
and a lance,
and
a
room,
and a shield.
Fine, do it.
Thank you, Merton Sire. Thank you, Burnsire.
I didn't do it for you. I did it for your sister. That's true love.
Aha! Your true intentions are revealed.
Good luck!
But why
would Burnsire
have a gesture like that? They've been there and argued so much, they're practically family. Our tournament guests are here. William Hale.
Beatrice Hale. And Ava Hale.
Very excited to see the tournament. You know, my son is going to compete.
You don't say?
Yes, I sent him to your kingdom many years ago to learn jousting.
Really? I'm afraid I don't remember you.
Oh, he had a letter introducing himself to you. I remember. I wrote it myself.
Fetch me all the correspondence I have for my friend here, Wilhelm. I'm sure we'll get to the bottom of this. What did you say his name was?
Wes Hale.
Wes Hale!
Everyone shouts his name. He must be the best knight you've got.
Well, perhaps. If so, he should do well in the tournament.
I understand you brought a prize for the winner of the tournament?
Well, my husband thought...
Not yet. The prize is a Sir prize. Right, dear? Kids.
Lords and ladies, peasants of all ages, let's get ready to joust! Let's meet our contestants. Here they are, the knights of the square table. The long knight. The short knight.
That's my son.
He looks familiar.
He has his father's eyes. We also have Thatcher Troutbottom. We have a late entrant. If it please your majesties, may I introduce the Dark Knight.
Thank you for the skill you are about to show us today. And we wish for you to remain safe so that you may joust again another day. And please do not harm any of our guests sitting at the tables. We just finished cleaning up from last time. And now, I'd like to present to you a man who's traveled a very long way to be here. A fellow monarch!
What? He's a butterfly?
No, he's a king. King Good Wilhelm.
Good knights. There has been rumor that I have a special prize for the winner of today's tournament. You know what they say about rumors. They're usually true. For the winner of today's tournament, you will receive my daughter Ava's hand in marriage. Yeah. Now there are a few rules to this. The winning knight must be A, still living at the end of the tournament, B, unmarried, and C, not be named Thatcher Troutbottom.
Nonsense. If Thatcher wins, he has every right to marry Ava. As long as you're single and still alive, Thatcher.
Knights, the first contest is of your horsemanship.
Horsemanship? Nobody said anything about a boat.
Go and get your horses. The top finishers in this race will advance to the next round. The route is around the tables and back here again. On your marks, get set,
go!
Long night. The long night gets three days. Up next, we have the dark night.
Has us funny. Turn a jester in a bucket, to a jester in a bucket, takes the place of a bucket. Thank you. At this time, the ladies of the court shall now bestow upon us a fine tune, the unfading fire.
Thank you.
singers, your singing is filled with all grace and beauty. Let us now sing our song.
Sounding joy, he rules the world with truth.
loved ones, friends, and family. Unfortunately, as does every endeavor, our celebration must come to a close. At this time, we would like to invite any former GCHS choir member to please rise and be recognized by our audience.
Lords and ladies, we've had a splendid night of feasting and general merriment. Alas, I must bid you a fond farewell. However, it is my wish that we gather in this great hall, year after year, to join in celebration of Christmas. In the meantime, may God bless you and your families. Farewell, and Godspeed. Our final song for you this evening will be Silent.